Okay, Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh and very good day. Okay, this session we want to discuss about the synchronous machine. Okay, same like DC machine. Yeah, DC machine is also can be divided by two part, generator and motor. Same synchronous machine here can be divided by two part, generator and also motor. Yeah, now, so for this section, yeah, for this section, we want to discuss about the, yeah, the first about the introduction of the synchronous generator. Yeah, for the past about the synchronous generator. Now, so and then salient pole rotor generator, non-salient pole rotor generators, different between salient and non-salient pole generator. And then principle operation. Yeah, we want to find the basic parameters, yeah, RA, and then short circuit current, phase voltage of the synchronous generator, internal generated voltage, equivalent circuit, voltage regulator, yeah, measured more measuring the model of the synchronous generator and parallel operation of AC generator means when, for example, when one generator operate first, after that, yeah, the second generator will be connected to the first generator. Now, so the to do how to do the operation two generator in parallel operation. Okay, now so remember when we discuss about the electrical machine, yeah, electrical machine, yeah, same for the stator on the for the generator and motor, yeah, we have the two terms, yeah, two terms. The first mechanical terms, yeah, mechanical term. In the mechanical term, we know that two parts. The first is rotor. Yeah, rotor, yeah, is mechanical part or rotating part. And the stator, yeah, stator is the stationary part. Yeah. Okay, so normally, yeah, also between rotor and stator, yeah, is separated by the air gap. And the second term is electrical terms. Yeah, electrical terms. The electrical term same is divided by two part. The first is armature. Yeah, armature. Armature is always is contract in the stator. Yeah, normally it is for produce the power, yeah, in the stator for the synchronous generator. And the second of the electrical terms is field. Yeah, field is the magnetic field component of electrical machine. Yeah, meaning the field, yeah, is generated in the rotor. Yeah. Because in the synchronous generator, the winding in the rotor will connected to the DC source, and so the magnetic field will be generated in the rotor, and then what we can call the rotating magnetic. Okay, and so we can see that the magnetic field can be provided by either electromagnet or permanent magnet mounted on either the rotor or stator. And so meaning the magnetic field, yeah, is developed by the rotor, yeah, because the rotor is constructed by the winding, and then the winding is plotted by the DC current, Yeah, the DC current, if the it is the DC current, yeah, the from the winding, yeah, DC current, the DC current flows through the winding in the rotor, and then because the rotor is moved by the fan over, nah, so in the rotor will generate the rotating magnet. The synchronous generator is also called as alternator. Yeah, alternator. Yeah, the alternator. And then I repeat again that the rotor magnetic field is produced by permanent magnet. If it is permanent magnet, it's constructed by the rotor, positive and not and short. Yeah, nah, so it is the permanent magnet. Or can by applying the DC current to rotor winding, yeah, to rotor winding. Maybe can, if it is rotor, yeah, it's the rotor, and then we have the contactor, and then the contactor, yeah, this brush, contactor, and then after that, can, if we want to supply the DC, DC current, flows through the winding that construct in the rotor, yeah, from the separated DC source, for example, from the battery can, or because this rotor is moved, yeah, it's moved, nah, so we can couple to the DC generator, yeah, construct the DC generator. DC generator can produce the DC current, and then can be connected to the connected to the winding of the rotor. Yeah, this one. Okay, so we can see the difference between AC machine and DC machine. Yeah, AC machine and DC machine. The first relate to the supply. Yeah, meaning if we discuss about the AC machine, means this AC machine works on AC supply. Yeah, AC supply meaning if the it is the AC motor, yeah, AC motor is supplied by the AC voltage, and then the DC machine work from the DC supply, mainly from the battery DC power supply or AC to DC power converter. Yeah, this one, yeah. Yeah, AC to be DC using inverter. Okay, and then in term of the supply system, yeah, supply system, AC machine can be single or three-phase. Meaning if the single is the AC machine is single-phase AC machine. If the three-phase supplies, meaning the AC machine is three-phase AC machine. And then, but the DC machine is only single-phase, meaning polarity positive and negative polarity, positive and negative terminal. Okay, and then starting, the AC machine needs starting mechanism for single-phase, not for three-phase. Yeah. Yeah, meaning the starting like this one before lah. Yeah. For the synchronous generator. And then for the DC machine using the self starting. Okay, in term of the stator and rotor. Wheel windings are on the rotor that produce magnetic wheel or rotor windings. Yeah, remember? Yeah, in the AC machine, wheel winding is construct on the rotor and then will produce the magnetic wheel. But in the DC machine, wheel winding is wound on the stator to produce magnetic wheel. Okay, it is different between DC and AC machine in term of the stator and the rotor. Yeah, and then in term of the wheel windings. Okay, I repeat again. Wheel windings in the AC machine, yeah, is on the rotor, but on the DC machine, the wheel winding is on the stator. And then brush and commutator. Okay, AC machine do not use brushes. They are very rough and have long life expectation. But in the DC ones, wheel motor are constructed with brush and commutator, which add to maintain, limit the speed, and usually reduce the life expectancy of brushed DC motor. Yeah, meaning the DC machine need the brush, yeah, to a brush and a commutator, yeah, to convert to be DC. And then speed control, yeah, for the AC machine, the speed can be controlled by varying the frequency. Yeah, by varying frequency, because we know that NS is equals 120 F over P. Yeah, and then we know that frequency is proportional to the speed. Now, so if frequency high, the speed is also high. But and then the DC machine, if you want to control the speed is controlled by varying the armature windings current. Yeah, meaning, because the winding, yeah, exactly for the, it is for the motor, yeah, for the motor speed motor, we want to control the motor speed. So please vary the current that flows through the armature winding. Okay, now so we can see. Okay, it is the first we want to discuss about the salience fall rotor generator. Yes, the magnetic fall on the rotor can be either salience or non-salience construction. Yes, salience means protracting or sticking out. Yeah, we can see here. Yeah, we can see here it is salience, yeah, salience, or we can call also sticking out. Okay, now so and then normally, yeah, for the salience fall of the synchronous generator, yeah, has four or more number of fall. Yeah, and then the winding can be construct here. Yeah, can be construct here. Yeah, we can see like this one. Yeah, we want the wire. Yeah, yeah, like this one, and then connect to here, connect to here, connect to here, connect to here. The last terminal here in the rotor, and then connect to the DC supply. Yeah, salience poles, magnetic pole that sticks out radially from the shaft of the rotor. Electromagnetic windings are around the pole itself. Okay, normally the salience fall in term of the number of fall is four or more falls. And then we can also can see the construction of the salient falls. Yeah, it is the stator. It is the stator. And then the stator is construct, the stator is put in winding also. Yeah, the winding is put it here. Yeah, here, here. And then it is the type of the salience fall. Yeah, salient fall here. We can see here. And then the winding is put it here for the rotor. When the rotor move, yeah, remember before the winding is float by the DC current, and then the rotor, yeah, rotor move. Yeah, DC current flow through the winding produce the magnetic, yeah, the magnetic wheel. So the rotor move, nah, so will produce the rotating magnet, and then arrive to the stator. Yeah, meaning the stator is induced the voltage. Nah, so the terminal of the stator will produce the voltage also. Okay, so we can see here. The right side, yeah, it is construction of the salience fall rotor. Yeah, salient fall rotor. How many number of the fall? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yeah, six fold. Yeah, we can see six fold. Yeah, now so we can see the winding here. The winding is 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 here. Connect together. We can see here. To connect to the exceeder in series, one part group of the winding connect to here in series to produce the fold for the knot and so number of knot and number of short is same. Yeah, and then connected to the DC supply. Okay, and then it is the non-salient spool of the rotor generator. Okay. So in terms of the construction, that the magnetic pole with windings embedded flush with the surface of the rotor. Electromagnetic windings embedded in notches on the surface of the rotor. Yeah, we can see here. Yeah, it is for the, let's say that this one is not short, not short. Yeah. And then we can see here that for the non-salient spool, yeah, the rotor is constructed by the sham slot. Yeah, sham slot, and then every slot is put it by the winding, yeah, to produce the fold. Yeah, for example, this for the knot and then this for the shock. Yeah. And then normally, yeah, the normally the non-salient folds in terms of number of folds is 2 folds or 4 folds. And then in terms of diameter and also the length of the rotor, we can see after this. Yeah, we can see this non-salient. It is non-salient fold rotor generator. Yeah, this one. We can see here like this one. Yeah. We can see in term of the length. We can see the structure of the rotor or the non-salient spool is long. Yeah, we can see here. And then normally the non-salient spool rotor generator, yeah, it is for the turbo generators. Yeah, turbo generators. Okay, and then we can list the difference between salience and non-salience rotor generator. Okay, for the salience, rotor has a large number of projecting or salience poles having the core bolt on the onto a heavy magnetic core of cast iron or GO steel of good magnetic quality. Yeah, now so if one rotor, yeah, if one rotor, and then it is construct to be salient pole. Yeah, if the number of the salient pole, meaning we want to increase the number of pole, yeah, the number of salient to be increased also. Now, so we'll increase the number of all the diameter of rotor to be increased. And then for the non-salient rotor consists of the smooth solid post steel cylinders having a number of slots for accommodating fill coil. Yeah, and so the construction of the non-salient rotor generator like a cylinder. Yeah, cylinder more longer if the compare to the salient in term of the length of the rotor, the non-salient rotor generator is longer than the salient pole rotor generator. And then we can see here salient pole machine are large in the diameter but smaller in axial length. I repeat again that for the salience rotor generator in term of diameter of the rotor is larger compared to the non-salience rotor generator. Diameter is larger but the length is shorter compared to the non-salient rotor generator. Okay, for the, I repeat, for the non-salient rotor generator, they are smaller in term of diameter, but longer in term of the length. And then for the salients, usually number of pole on the rotor is 4 or more in term of the number of pole. And the non-salient in term of the number of pole, 2 or 4. Yeah. Okay, and then the difference for the salient for rotor creates considerable air turbulence in the air gap between the rotor and stator as the rotor rotates, resulting a relative high windage loss. Yeah, meaning we can see if it is salient, yes, salient pole, yeah, like this one. Now, so there is empty space lah, I can call, yeah. Now, so it is potential for the air, and then after that, the air losses will be increased, yeah. On the non-salience, windage losses is less compared than the salience. The relative smooth surface of the rotor reduces windage losses, that is, the energy loss to moving the air around the air gap between the rotor and the stator, XS Van effect. Yeah. And then in terms of the speed, salience, for medium speed, the speed is around 120 to 500 RPM. For the non-salient, has the higher speed, is around 1,000 to 3,000 RPM. Okay, and then in terms of the capacity, the salience for rotor generator, lower power generation, the capacity is around 800 megawatt. It is for hydro power plant. And then the non-salient, higher power generation is around 1,500 megawatt. Okay, for the turbine. Yeah, this one. And so meaning the we can conclude that the non-salient, it is, we can call also the turbo generator, means the capacity of the non-salient synchronous generator is higher than salient rotor generator in term of the capacity. Yeah. Okay, and then in term of the construction, we can call the salients, yeah, four are sticking out from the space. Yeah. And then the non-salient unslotted portion of the cylinder acts as pole. Okay, and the salient constructed winding on the poles and a uniform air gap. Okay, non-salient, one distributed winding and essentially uniform air gap. Okay, for the salients, mechanical wing premover use are water turbine. Okay, mechanical strong premover use are steam turbine electric motor. Yeah, it is same, yeah, the last and this one is same. Yeah. Okay, it is the difference between the salience and non-salience. Okay, and then we can see how the synchronous generator works. Okay, remember I repeat again. Yeah, the first, yeah, because we know the basic principle. What is generator? Generator is a machine that converts mechanical energy to be electrical energy. Meaning mechanical, yeah, rotor is part of the mechanical, rotor is rotating part. So will produce the electric will be produced in the stator. Rotor is constructed by the winding, and then the winding is connected to the DC source. DC source can from the separately DC source battery or connected to the others like the DC generator, that couple together using the DC generator. For example, the DC generator produce the DC current, and then DC current connect to the rotor winding, yeah, to produce the magnetic field. After that, rotor move. Rotor move. Yeah, because rotor move, now so the magnetic wheel will move also. That we can call the rotating wheel. Yeah, rotating wheel. After that, because the stator yeah is also constructed by the winding, the rotating magnetic arrive to the winding. Yeah, when they arrive to the winding, means will produce the induced voltage. Yeah, this one. The induced voltage is given by minus N d flux over dt, or E induced voltage is equal to Cn multiply flux. Okay, we can see here, meaning there is there is the change of magnetic flux. Yeah, there is the change of magnetic flux to the time. Yeah, to the time. This one. Yeah, it is the formulation, basic formulation that induced voltage generated on the stator. Okay, now we can see the video for synchronous generator, how the this synchronous generator operate. Okay, yeah, we can see here. Yeah, I repeat again, yeah, you can see. Okay, now the winding is on the rotor. Yeah, then the rotor winding is plowed by the DC current. Means the magnetic field will produce here. Yeah, because the rotor is moved by the frame over. Yeah, in the rotor will occur the rotating magnet. Nah, so this one ya. Okay, now we want to know, yeah, the construction of the rotor. Yeah, this rotor. Yeah, this one is rotor. Now the type of the rotor is salience fall. Now this one is the rotor winding. The rotor winding is plowed by the DC current. Yeah, we can see. Yeah, rotor di mana itu will produce. Yeah, now so it is the type of the salient fold rotor. Okay, we can see here like this one. Yeah, the winding rotor has two terminal. It is for the positive and negative terminal that connected to the DC source. Okay, now this winding in the stator, yeah, this winding in the stator to produce same north and south wall. Okay, and then we can see here it is the end of the stator winding, meaning the induced voltage will generate it in the two terminals on the stator generator. Okay. So the sinusoidal waveform will be generated. Yeah, so because there is the change of flux, yeah, there is the change the different flux, yeah, to the time. Nah, so if it is the connected to the loop, current can flow. Nah, so the waveform is sinusoidal. You can see it. So, yeah. Okay, now we want to know how the DC current can be supplied to the rotor winding. Yeah, this one we can see. Yeah, using the slip ring because it is moved. Yeah, it is the DC generator. Yeah, because connected the rot meaning the rotor synchronous generator is coupled to the rotor of the DC generator. Yeah, to produce the DC current, and then DC current will connect it to the rotor winding of the synchronous generator. Okay, so we can call here the self-excited generator. Okay, can also if we want to connect to the separately DC source. For example, it is positive and negative connected to the outside of the constructed of the generator using the battery. But remember, the battery can be low in term of the voltage. And so, but this case, because it is continue, the rotor of the DC generator will move together, and so will continue produce the DC source to supply to the rotor winding of synchronous generator. Okay, we can see the our slide back. Okay, and then we can see that two common approach to supply. I repeat again, to supply the DC supply to rotor windings, the first supply the power from external DC source to rotor by means slip ring and brushes. Yeah, it is meaning I can see I can call from the battery. The second supply the DC power from special power source mounted directly on the shaft of the generator. It is we can call the shaft excited generator. On the largest scale machine, brushless exciter are used to supply the DC field current to machine. A brushless exciter is small AC generator with the each wheel circuit mounted on the stator and each armature circuit mounted on the rotor shaft. Okay, it is we can see. It is the overall construction of the synchronous generator. Yeah. Nah, so we can see here it is the exciter, yeah, exciter, meaning for produce the DC source, yeah, this one. And we can see also in term of the length of this generator, we can call this one is one type of the non-silent, salient rotor generator. Yeah, because it is the long. Okay, so we can see also here. Yeah, it is a construction of the synchronous generator. It is rotor, and this one is stator. Yeah, this shaft using the bearing rotor stator, and this one is housing. Yeah. Okay, and then same this one we can see here. Yeah, we can see here. It is like the for the large generator, yeah, large generator, yeah. Okay, and then same, it is the large generator rotor completely assembly, yeah. Now, so we can see it is, we can see from here that we can call it is not non-silent rotor generator also. And then from here, we can see large hydro generator for the vertical. If you can see here, in term of the length of the rotor, okay, it is short. And then in term of diameter, large. Okay, we can call here this type is salience rotor generator. Yeah, same like this one. It is the for the large silent, yeah, salient fault hydro generator. Yeah, because we can see here in term of diameter is big, and then see here can also it is salient rotor generator. Okay, it's enough here. Thank you very much.